Hi everyone, let's take a brief look how the decision tree works. Suppose you want to teach your baby to pick winter family vacation photo. You may say to consider snow, human, and the number of members from the pictures to your baby. So we definitely know the cartoon is not a family photo, so we can split these pictures and we have the remaining here using the cartoon characters attribute. And we can split again using this winter attribute if the picture is winter. That's what we want. And we can split again these remaining using the more than one person attribute. If the picture is just a single person, it's not the family photo. And now we have the picture is not the cartoon character and winter and more than one person. This is the family winter photo. So now your baby can recognize more pictures using this decision tree. If we give this Elsa, then your baby say, this is a cartoon, this is not a family photo. And here, if you give this photo, then your baby is going to take a look. This one is not the cartoon character, but it's not the winter. So your baby say it's not the winter vacation photo. And if your baby take this photo, then it's not the cartoon, it's winter, and it has more than one person. So your baby say, this is our family vacation photo. So your baby is smart enough. And as you already know that this baby is the machine and the machine learned from you. Congratulations. So decision tree has two main concepts. At the first time, the machine doesn't know anything like a baby. And we need to give the problem, define problem, and we need to give the pictures like we gave 8 pictures to the baby. And we need to extract the data from our training set. I'm going to show you on the next page. And we are going to build a tree from Python. And after that, we can run our machine, deploy the machine, and the machine can answer the testing data set, like the baby answered the question. So let's build the decision tree. And here's the extracting data. We had 8 pictures like this, and I extracted this data, have the 3 attributes like cartoon, winter, and more than one person. So this picture is not a cartoon, and it's in winter, has more than one person. So the answer for family winter photo is yes. And this one is not a cartoon, it's winter, but it has just one person. So the family winter photo, no, it's not, and so on. So at the first time, we need to decide the first attribute to split the data. So we had a cartoon, winter, more than one person attribute. So cartoon, winter, and more than one person. And which attribute is more effective to build a decision tree? Well, let's take a look. If you use the cartoon characters, then we can split out 4 cartoon characters like this, and the remaining is going to be 4. And if we use winter as attribute of the first one, then we split out 3 data here, and the remaining is going to be 5. And if we use the more than one person, then the remaining is going to be 5. So looks like this cartoon character split out something unnecessary data more than the other. So cartoon character is the one we want to use at the first time. And next one, we need to split again using the other attribute with winter or more than one person. And the same concept, if we use winter, then we split out 1 picture. And if we use more than one person, we split out 2 pictures. So this one is more effective than the winter. So the final of decision tree is going to be like this: cartoon, more than one person, and winter. And your machine can answer with this data set that this picture is the family winter photo. So congratulations. Now you know the machine learning decision tree concepts. And before we go over to next video, let's learn some little bit about the terminologies in the decision tree. The first one is the entropy. You can see left and the right room here, and the left room is more messy than the right room. And we can say the left room, the messy room, is the high entropy, and the right room is the low entropy. So entropy is the measure of the messiness. And the next one is information gain. Information gain is base entropy minus new entropy. So at the first time, we had the 8 pictures, and after we used cartoon characters, now we have just 4 pictures. So 8 compared to 4, is less information gain, and the information gain is 4 here. And the second one, information gain is 3 because we had 8 data, and after we use winter, we have 3 data. And here, the information gain is 3. And we choose next attribute using the highest information gain, and as you can see here, the left side one is the highest information gain, so we used cartoon character as the first attribute. We are going to go over this information gain and the entropy on next video with mass calculation, but if you want to skip the mass calculation, then you can go to next video, which is the Python implementation for the decision tree. Okay, that's it, and I'll see you on the next video.